I have question papers with me. And the domain of geography is not paper one alone. So you will find few questions in paper two as well. Because in geography, we deal with geopolitics. We call it political geography also. So what you call international relationship, we call it geopolitics. And geopolitics is resource based. And geopolitics is about influencing the foreign policy of the other country in your favor. Why China does all these political gimmicks or use that pressure technique along the border? Their strategic, China making a strategic alliance with North Korea and Russia. India is having a strategic alliance, military alliance with United States, Australia, Japan, etc., South Korea. There are two factions, powerful factions in the world at loggerheads, playing their own political gimmicks and doing political maneuvering all the time. What is the purpose of it? We geographers also explain what is the purpose for it. And we are the one who can explain the boundary disputes through our understanding of geography. And then the resource base of the countries and the trade relations. Because every political relationship is based on the economic principles. That is for sure. It is the economics which is driving the entire world. I really agree to it. So in paper 2 also, you will find that geopolitics and political geography has some questions there. Maybe 30 to 50 marks question will be in paper 2 also. So it's not about paper 1. Paper 1 GS is all right. 150 marks for geography, because what you call social issues, for us they are our simple topics. And you can see in the geography syllabus also that we are also teaching urbanization, population and demography, secularism, secularization, regionalism, nationalism, all we are having in our geography optional syllabus. So a geography optional person will have a complete domain over 150 marks, including geography and environment and the social issues, etc. I hope you understand this. Then in paper 2 also we have around 30 to 50 marks we can capture from geopolitics, and you can write beautifully if you have understanding of the boundary disputes and the geopolitics and the world organizations, how they function and how they, India's role in South Asia, India's role in world politics, geopolitics of Indian Ocean. This is all we have in political geography. Please go and see the syllabus of geography optional. What I am trying to tell you, that when I was looking into the GS paper for last half an hour, I was just going through the GS paper for last 5 years. The most of the questions are either from social geography, please understand, socio-cultural geography, or from political geography, or from environmental geography, or economic geography, and only one or two questions are from physical geography. This is how probably the student community who have been told by the seniors, by the teachers, coach, so-called mentors, they have been told that geography means physical geography and mapping. No. Geography means फिजिकल ज्योग्राफी इज ओनली वन पार्ट ऑफ इट, इट इज ओनली 30% ऑफ ज्योग्राफी, एंड 30% ऑफ ज्योग्राफी इज इन्वायरमेंट. 30% इज फिजिकल, 30% इज बायो इन्वायरमेंट ज्योग्राफी, एंड 40% में 20% इज इकोनॉमिक एंड 20% इज ह्यूमन ज्योग्राफी. सो दिस इज हाउ वी डिवाइड ज्योग्राफी. एंड यूपीएससी, आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट जीएस, सो यूपीएससी व्हेन दे आर क्राफ्टिंग क्वेश्चंस, व्हाट दे आर डूइंग, दे आर टेकिंग वन क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम ईच सेक्शन. सो देर इज ए बैलेंस ऑफ क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम द इंटायर सिलेबस ऑफ ज्योग्राफी. व्हाइल यू हैव लर्न that what is geography, the physical part is geography, a study of mountain is geography, a study of ocean current is geography. That is the real problem in prelims also, because in prelims also lot of questions are coming from other than physical geography, but students believe that oh, whatever comes from physical and mapping is geography, rest is different subjects, so they can categorize it as forestry, agriculture. They try to categorize it as what, environmental science. That is where the market is badly mistaken, or it was badly misguided. 5 years I have been really off from Karol Bagh area, and that was the English belt. So I think the other what, क्या बोलूँ मैं, फैकल्टीज और अदर मेंबर्स, अदर पीपल ज्वाइनिंग द रेस ऑफ कोचिंग एंड टीचिंग, दे कुड नॉट कन्वे टू द स्टूडेंट्स दैट ज्योग्राफी इज नॉट फिजिकल एंड मैपिंग, ज्योग्राफी इज पॉलिटिकल, पॉलिटिकल ज्योग्राफी का एक पार्ट होता है, ह्यूमन ज्योग्राफी जिसमें ट्राइब, रेस, रिलीजन, सेकुलराइजेशन, रीजनलिज्म सब आएगा. So I'm inviting you to look into the syllabus of geography optional only to substantiate that what I said is absolutely correct, is unquestionable. I know you trust me. My purpose is to guide you for general studies, and I'm simply guiding you, telling you the truth of general studies, that if you are going to prepare on physical geography and mapping and going to write your mains examination, you will be at a loss. You are badly mistaken. You are misguided. So, you will have to see the geography optional syllabus to understand that what is the domain of geography. And even in GS, few topics from political geography, few from social geography, few from environmental geography, few from economic geography, they all must be taken up. Then it's a complete geography package. It's not like the physical geography and the Indian geography. Indian geography, maybe you are learning Himalayas and monsoon and vegetation and soil. So even that is physical geography. But what questions will be asked from India will be resource. Water resource pe questions hai. Questions are asked on mangroves. Questions are asked on food processing industry, and there is a question on ocean current also. So ocean current to geography lagega, oh, it's geography, but there are so many parts of geography. Now everything is not possible through teaching. Lot of things you have to gain by yourself, right? Something you should try of your own, because the domain is so huge. Some of the topics like mangroves, ab environment wale log bolenge mangrove mera hai, geography ke hum hai, hum bole bhai tumhara kaise hai. Geography mein jab mains mein question pucha mangroves pe, global warming pe questions hai, climate change pe questions hai, वाटर रिसोर्स पे क्वेश्चन है, वाटर स्ट्रेस पे क्वेश्चन है, बाउंड्री डिस्प्यूट्स पे है, रिवर वाटर डिस्प्यूट्स पे है, इंटरलिंकिंग ऑफ रिवर्स पे है, फ्लड पे आएगा, ड्राउट पे आएगा, नेचुरल हैजार्ड पे आएगा, रिसोर्स पे आएगा, रिसोर्स स्कार्सिटी, रिसोर्स कर्स, रिसोर्स मोबिलाइजेशन, रिसोर्स पे कितना थ्योरी है, रिसोर्स एंटाइटलमेंट। सो टू बी ऑनेस्ट आई मस्ट टेल यू दैट व्हेन यू अप्रोच ज्योग्राफी, अप्रोच विथ होलिस्टिक, हैव ए होलिस्टिक अप्रोच, एंड व्हेन यू हैव होलिस्टिक अप्रोच देन यू नीड टू लर्न द डिफरेंट सेगमेंट्स ऑफ ज्योग्राफी। I will read out few questions. Paper 3 is also cropping pattern and agriculture and food processing industry and environment and disaster management. Tum dekho to paper 3 mein bhi kitna geography ka topic hai. Livestock, fishing, blue revolution, white revolution, pink revolution, sab aa jayega usme. The moment it is written livestock, to livestock mein kya aa jayega? रेड रेवोल्यूशन, मीट रेवोल्यूशन भी आएगा, पिंक भी आएगा, वाइट रेवोल्यूशन आएगा, ब्लू रेवोल्यूशन आएगा। तो यू हैव टू जस्टिफाई द टॉपिक्स, सी द टॉपिक्स एंड यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट दैट व्हाट ऑल कुड बी द सब टॉपिक्स ऑफ इट एंड प्रिपेयर ऑन देम। सो आई एम थिंकिंग ऑफ रीडिंग सम ऑफ द क्वेश्चंस। Question number 4, I think this is 2020. Assess the impact of global warming on coral life system with example. Now this question has come from the Wilkinson's report. A Wilkinson report se question hai. Current nahi hai. Wilkinson report was published in 2001 or 2. Pretty old report. But the question is on, this question is from oceanography on coral reef system, and the question has been connected with global warming. So this is new era of geography. They are not going to ask you what are landforms, like most of the teachers are dealing with landform. They are not asking it. What are rocks? They are not asking me. What is earth interior? They are not interested. Look at the questions which are actually deep. So you have to be more contemporary than traditional and ethical in your own ways. Look at next question. So first was on global warming and coral reef. Second is on mangrove. Discuss the causes of depletion of mangroves. Explain their importance in coastal ecology. Maintaining coastal ecology, how mangroves are protecting the coast from tsunami or tidal wave or coastal ecology, matlab fishing bhi aa jayega usme, animal kingdom bhi aa jayega, aquatic life pe likhna hai. So what is the role of mangroves in their biodiversity which is found in the mangrove, the bioproductivity which is there, bioproductivity, the organic mass which is being created, the planktons which thrive, the algae which thrive in the mangrove system, the primary production which is taking place in the mangrove system, how they sustain the ecology. So why we need mangroves, and mangroves are features of tropical ocean, hai na? To mangroves ke bare mein janna hai, what are mangroves, how mangroves are having the buttress roots going deep into the, they provide mechanical support to the trees, and they can, you know, they can brave out their strongest waves and the tsunamis. So once we remove the mangroves, your coastal area becomes more prone to natural disaster. Chalo, it's not I'm not here to discuss the answer and all, but I'm just trying to point out that what is the exact nature of civil services today, and how the teachers are only teaching the superficial traditional things and just running away. They teach what they know. They need to work hard on their own knowledge. They need to work hard on the syllabus and the kind of questions, the changes which have taken place. And then they have to deliver and guide you, at least tell you that this is what is the realm of civil services now. So mangrove. Two questions taken. Now third question is, can the strategy of regional resource based manufacturing, regional Bihar, resource based, what are the resources in Bihar, manufacturing, help in promoting employment in India? Now please use your brain, if it is at all there. Use yourself, apply yourself. That this question has been asked in paper 1, and this question is definitely not from history. Aur history ka to question nahi hai na, so it must be from geography, because the syllabus mentions paper 1 is history, geography and social issues. So ye question to geography ka hi hai na, this is geographical question. Resource base, say industry, and the linkages between employment. I remember I have given you one example of the Deccan Plateau, how the geology to the soil, to the cotton growing, to the textile industry, to the migrations and the development, how geography is linked physical to the human growth. Pura linked, economic development se pura linked hai geography. So until you understand these linkages, how would you ever able to respond to or make any good answer writing? Paper 1 is none. I mean, hardly there are any students who are able to score more in paper 1. They are scoring around 90 to 110. That's the average out of 250. Because none of them are able to write. They are writing some small things from their general knowledge. So this is how, if you have geography optional. Oh, I am marketing for myself. कोई बात नहीं है, ट्रूथ तो यही है कि इफ यू हैव ज्योग्राफी ऑप्शनल, यू हैव इन डेप्थ एनालिसिस ऑफ ऑल द रिसोर्स एंड एम्प्लॉयमेंट, एंड सो 150 कैन बी अप्रोच्ड हियर. एंड इन पेपर 2 आल्सो, आई विल सी द पेपर 2 क्वेश्चंस एंड आई विल शो यू दैट दे आर मोस्टली फ्रॉम ज्योग्राफी ऑप्शनल, सम ऑफ देम आर ज्योग्राफी ऑप्शनल. पेपर 3 में अगेन द डोमेन विल ओपन अप, इफ यू अलाउ मी फॉर. अब नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन क्या है, डिस्कस द factors of localization of agro-based food processing industries of northwestern India. Northwestern India, green revolution belt, green revolution padhna hoga. Cropping pattern, crop combination of this region padhna hoga. Then you can talk about na agro-based industries. Nahin, Punjab is growing cotton or not? Punjab is growing sugarcane or not? They are the Punjab is growing pulse or not, aisle seeds or not. Punjab meaning Punjab, Haryana, the command area of Indira Gandhi Canal, the western UP, this entire region the question is demanding. So you need to understand the agricultural regionalization, the cropping pattern, the story of green revolution, and then you can write on such questions. What is my feeling, that you need to have a very comprehensive understanding of the syllabus of geography, then you will be able to perform and write. Question ka nature bahut alag sa hai yaar, isko dekho. Factors of localization pucha tha. Okay, next, right. Northwestern India mein factors of localization mein, you will have the national capital territory, the 7 crore population, the market based economy, the economic magnet is Delhi, which has huge urban demand of food processing, you know, products, agro products. So market also is one of the factor. How the green revolution has done wonders, and how the Punjab farmers have become capitalistic farmers, and how they use modern inputs and technology for growing vegetable, milk, even the very high quality cash crops, sugarcane, cotton. Ekore, what makes the Indian society unique in sustaining to culture? What makes Indian society unique in sustaining its culture? Why the history has witnessed so many invasions, and why the other civilizations came here and they got assimilated with our culture, they enriched our culture, and the Pashupati cult of Mohenjo-daro and Harappa that continues even today. How the cultural traits from the ancient time, how the Vedic hymns, the Vedic chants, the Upanishads, the philosophy of Om Shanti Om, they all continue today. Why we are growing as a civilization? Others could not do it. Ye question kitna khoobsurat question hai. What makes the Indian society unique? Sustaining its culture. कैसे यहाँ का कल्चर सस्टेन किया है? वॉट आर द फैक्टर्स? तो फैक्टर्स में यू विल हैव टू राइट, यू विल हैव टू टॉक अबाउट द फिजिकल फैक्टर, यू विल हैव टू टॉक अबाउट नॉन फिजिकल, नॉन फिजिकल में फिर हिस्टोरिकल, सोशल, रिलीजियस, फिलोसफिकल, इंस्टीट्यूशनल सब आने लगेगा. दी इट्स अ ब्यूटिफुल क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम कल्चरल ज्योग्राफी. देखो कहाँ से क्वेश्चन पूछ रहा है. What are the challenges to our cultural practices in the name of secularism? See the geography ka syllabus, optional ka syllabus, dekho, likha hua hai secularism, culture of India, sab hai geography ke domain mein. They are not sociology. They could be sociology. Sociology also borrows something from us. Geography is the first subject is geography in the world. This is not, main nahi bol raha hun, Immanuel Kant bol raha hai, Kant. Philosopher Kant has said the first subject is geography, because when men appeared on this earth, they evolved as man, Homo sapiens sapien, and they witnessed the physical, you know, they were awestruck by the nature, the magnificent nature around him. And the first script which the man has written is geographical. Even the songs of Vedas are geographical. Because the first hymn is dedicated to fire, because man observed fire, feared fire. There was a sense of gratitude for fire also. Sense of gratitude was because when the wild animals will attack, there will be a fire ring and the family will save themselves. So there was a sense of gratitude for fire. So first shloka of mantra of Veda is devoted to God Agni, and Agni becomes a God. छोड़ो ये सब, कभी बैठ के आराम से we can discuss on coffee about India culture, secularization, the strong fabrics of India. But how empowered you feel when you have obviously a good understanding of this subject. Okay, like many more questions are there. What is water stress? How and why does it differ regionally in India? Water stress, water crisis. Crisis is the aftermath stage, the late stage. It starts with crisis, then it becomes what? क्या बोला मैंने अभी? It becomes hazard, then it becomes calamity, then it becomes disaster. तो भारत में भी disaster का stress नहीं है, water का stress है. Water का stress मतलब water resource का scarcity. Water is required for drinking, for livestock raising, for agricultural practices, for industries. Water is required. The rivers are gradually drying up. Global warming and all, we can talk about the ice caps which are melting in Himalayas, and the Himalayan rivers are becoming non-perennial from perennial. Bahut sari cheeze hain. So we can think of what is water stress. Matlab, all I am trying to tell you that geography is not limited to the physical part. And if you are good in one part of it, say you are good in physical part but not good in human geography, not good in economic geography, not good in political geography, then you will not be able to write. And more or less you can understand that most of the geography questions are having a concern of environment. So most questions are from environmental concerns. So environmental geography becomes so important. so important. Okay, and social geography becomes really important. Economic and social geography is important. I was just trying to point out some of the realities, because one of my dear student, he pointed out that, sir, from your classes we are not able to cover up questions, one or two questions may come. So I'm telling you that physical geography ka bhi ek chota part hai, there is only a small part of physical geography, that is climatology. So you have done climatology, and climatology may be you have climate change and so many topics to come which will be taken with environment, that is what I guess. So when you have how can the mountain ecosystem be returned from be restored from the negative impact of development initiatives and tourism? Mountain tourism, mountain ecosystem, degeneration of mountain ecosystem, that's another question. Again with environmental concern, the questions are mostly from environmental concern. Geography has moved into a realm where there is nothing like geography, it's mostly now environmental geography always. And PT may, when the questions are asked from environmental geography, people declare that they are not coming from geography, they are coming from environment. And I'm telling you that environmental sciences are highly specialized science. UPSC ask, does UPSC ask any question from MSc mathematics or from mechanical engineering? Does UPSC ask any question from agronomical sciences? No. General studies ka paper will not be based on any specialized science. General studies meaning general studies, and general study of environment and agriculture will be geography. So geography is in preliminary examination is representing the minimum of 30 and maximum of 40 questions. But people say geography has only 12 questions, 16 questions. They categorize because they feel that geography is only physical and mapping. So they take out the questions from physical and mapping, and they say 12 questions from geography. And then they say 18 questions from environment, 5 questions from forestry, 5 questions from agriculture. This is what they are doing. अरे भाई, फॉरेस्ट्री से यूपीएससी पीटी में क्वेश्चन क्यों पूछेगी, बताओ? जस्टिफाई योर ज्योग्राफी एंड देन गेट सो मेनी क्वेश्चंस। पेपर 1-3 तो बहुत मैसिव इंपैक्ट है ज्योग्राफी का। हाउ इज इफिशियंट एंड अफोर्डेबल अर्बन मास ट्रांसपोर्ट की टू द रैपिड इकोनॉमिक डेवलपमेंट ऑफ इंडिया? इफिशियंट एंड अफोर्डेबल अर्बन, ये MRTS है, मास रैपिड ट्रांजिट सिस्टम, MRTS पे क्वेश्चन आया हुआ है। ट्रांसपोर्टेशन ज्योग्राफी पे क्वेश्चन आया हुआ है। पेपर 1 है तो इसको इकोनॉमिक्स तो नहीं बोलेंगे ना, समझ रहे हो ना कम से कम कि ज्योग्राफी का डोमेन क्या है, कहाँ से क्वेश्चन आ रहा है। क्वेश्चन आ रहा है ट्रेड एंड ट्रांसपोर्ट ज्योग्राफी से, जो हमारे ऑप्शनल के सिलेबस में लिखा हुआ है, MRTS लिखा हुआ है, ACZ लिखा हुआ है, EZ लिखा हुआ है, पाइपलाइन लिखा हुआ है, पोर्ट्स लिखा हुआ है, रोड एंड रेलवे नेटवर्क लिखा हुआ है। तो उसको जब पढ़ोगे तब ना ये सॉल्व करोगे, जब वही नहीं पढ़ोगे तो ये कैसे सॉल्व होगा? दैट इज माई क्वेश्चन। यू आर लर्निंग लैंडफॉर्म, यू आर लर्निंग अर्थ इंटीरियर, क्रस्ट मेंटल कोर, एंड थिंकिंग ऑफ राइटिंग दिस काइंड ऑफ ज्योग्राफी, इम्पॉसिबल। So the question which you raised, that we are not getting from, the questions are coming from, pata nahi kahan se aa raha hai sir, kaisa aa raha hai sir, this is how I have taken up this challenge and explaining you all this. Ek aur question cultural region se hai, do we have cultural pockets of small India all over the nation? Elaborate with example. कल्चरल रीजनलाइजेशन में सब कल्चराइजेशन, इस पर यह पूछा हुआ है। आर वी लूजिंग आवर लोकल आइडेंटिटी फॉर द ग्लोबल आइडेंटिटी? ये ग्लोबलाइजेशन से क्वेश्चन है। तो अगर तुम देखोगे ज्योग्राफी के ऑप्शनल सिलेबस में जो लास्ट टर्म लिखा हुआ है, दैट इज ग्लोबलाइजेशन एंड आवर आइडेंटिटी करके ही कुछ लिखा हुआ है। तो दिस क्वेश्चंस आर एक्चुअली कमिंग फ्रॉम geography, and maybe some of the question will coincide with the society or the probably the sociology. The sociology students can also solve some 3-4 questions, 3 to 5 questions they can do here, maybe on women, maybe on culture, maybe on maybe on secularization. They can do it also. I'm not saying that sociology will not have its say here, but out of 250 questions, sociology will be hardly standing for 30 to 50 marks, and geography will stand for 150 marks, because sociology ka jo topics hai, that naturally comes under geography. I hope only by going through 5-10 classes on a small part of physical geography, you will not start believing that your teacher was incapable, or you are incapable, or geography se question aata hi nahi hai. Geography is not so important, the questions are not coming. So I tell you that in geography you must have a different approach. Now divide your geography. Physical geography is one part. Hot plumes were asked, global warming se question could be asked. So have 4 parts of geography, at least 4 parts, if not 5, then have 4 parts of geography. So the first part will be, I will give you the structure and how you have to approach. So for geography, you do one thing. This is your physical geography, and in physical geography you have to learn some of the concepts from geomorphology, climatology, oceanography, and then leave. 3 topic hi yahan pe karo. Do these 3 topics, okay? Then you have environmental geography. Environmental geography mein you will have soil. What we call it? We call it biogeography. We call it biogeography. और soil geography और pedology तो नहीं आएगा, लेकिन soil पढ़ना है तुमको, soil. And then you have environmental part, ecology and environment, environment and ecology. Okay, so divide the environmental geography in 2 parts, and the 3rd part which you must divide is the contemporary issues. And isi mein you must complete your disaster, natural disaster and disaster management. And here itself, natural disaster ke pehle ka jo stage hota hai na, hota hai natural hazard. Natural hazard hoga. To natural hazards, natural disaster, disaster management, environmental crisis, ye sab isme aa jayega. Sab isme aa jayega. And maybe either in climatology you can learn global warming and its impact. And its impact. Ye aise karna hoga. Or climate change. Climate change. Ye topics ko climatology mein kar lo. Or here in environment you can talk about global warming and climate change. So you have both options, either with climatology or with environmental geography. Because if you learn environmental sciences, they try to make it more science. They go into the plant genetics and animal evolution and gene pool and all. We make environmental geography very practical in approach. We talk about the consequences, the causes and consequences. So this approach will help you in general studies. You don't have to become a specialist. Geography, it is said that you have to be jack of all, master of none. He is a great geographer who is jack of all, master of none. So you have environmental geography, physical kar lo, environmental geography. Now I can tell you one more thing, like in geomorphology, say you have mining. The mining and environmental degradation, ye bhi ho sakta hai. Yani environmental geography is hidden in geomorphology, in climatology. Oceanography mein kya hota hai? You learn about marine ecology. You learn about marine ecology. You also learn about marine resources. They are very important. The marine ecology, marine resources, learn about them also. So in marine ecology, you have coral reef. You have the fishing belts. You have the Sargasso Sea. You have the subpolar marine ecology. You have the equatorial ecology. You have so many divisions. You have the mangroves. So when you talk about all this holistically, then you have the resources. Marine resources kya hai? To isme bhi minerals, energy, renewable energy, non-renewable energy. It just goes on. So, I mean, if you can restructure your geography and prepare good notes on it, you are going to cover around 300 marks in your entire mains GS. Mains GS mein 300 cover kar dega ye geography. Then physical environment PT mein bhi around 30-40 cover kar dega. So physical, environmental, then you have next is what? Next is your economic geography, but I tell you it shall be in the context, more context of India. So let's write here Indian geography, and Indian geography, you can talk about the physical India, and then economic geography of India, the human geography of India. So economic may, you can further have resource, industry, agriculture, trade and transport. So economic geography can further be divided. Similarly, human geography can be divided into population geography, cultural geography, at least population geography, cultural geography, and political geography, and then urbanization. Ye char part human geography ka bhi kar lo, economic ka bhi char part kar lo, human ka bhi char part kar lo, and then Indian geography mein again you will have the environmental geography of India. Yahan fir environment ko lana hoga. So here you will have the environment and ecology of India, and with reference to India, the natural disasters and everything. Now this is a complete picture of geography. Now other than this, you have to do what all? Mapping. So world mapping plus India mapping. Now, I feel it looks very vast for you, but no, it's not very vast. Geomorphology, 5 to 7 days. Climatology, 10 days. 15. Oceanography, 5 days. 20 days for physical. This will take 7 days. 5 to 7 days. So, say, world mapping and physical sab mila ke kar lo 30 days. Environmental geography, soil geography, 5. Environment ecology, say 8 or 10. Disaster management, 3 to 5. So 15 to 5, this is 20 days. So 30 plus 20, 50. And Indian geography mein, you can have another 20 days. So 50, so it will be roughly around 60, 65 days of effort. And your geography is very much done. I hope you understood this. I still want you to work hard by yourself also. Work on your syllabus and work on your what? We will also give you the great support. We are doing it and we were doing it